Hello, I'm Alan. Welcome to Enots Engineering. In today's video, we start making the spindle for the drill grinding jig. The spindle is turned between centres, some screw cutting on the end, a taper for an ER20 collet, and we also mill some flat.
Using the pedestal drill.
We'll also start making the indexing ring. So let's go into the workshop and see how we do it. I've put my boring bar in the tool post and I just want to machine a chamfer on the inside that I can use for a centre. Because the drilling's left a bit of a burr on the end here, I need to face that off. So that'll fit in there nicely. I've turned it around in the chuck and I've marked the length that I need to finish the collet holder. On this end, exactly the same as the other end. I've drilled a hole through, machined a 30 degree cone so my centres will fit. I'm holding it true on the centre, the tailstock revolving centre. Set up the lathe centres, driving plate and the dog. What I want to do is machine this down to fit the spindle block up to about 20mm from the end. I've had to put my tool at an angle because I can't get right to the end. Now I'm using the revolving centre. So the first job I'll do is to true this up for the full length. Finished turning this between centres, and before I take it out, what I want to do is put an undercut in the middle, so that'll go in that way. I want to put an undercut here so that this spindle lock doesn't damage the bearing surface. It's only a few thou just to stop that. I'll give that a polish. Let's check what the diameter is. That's about 5 thou lower there than the rest. I'll try that in the bearing lock. Goes in there, gets tight. I'll just measure this. That's 7.14½. This is 7.15. So I've got half a thou difference between going in. So I need to polish off this half a thou till I can get it to fit. That's the block. That fits through now. I can rotate it. It's a bit tight, but it'll slacken off as I use it. So next is to do this end. 1 inch. Set up to cut a 1.5mm pitch thread. I've set up the gears for cutting a 1.5mm thread. This is the tool I'm using, 60 degree. The problem I have on this, that's a normal thread setting gauge, but on this one, the 60 degree, you can see, being a small tool, the 60 degree, you could put that anywhere on there. Most of the tool is in the cutout on the end. So what I've done is use a square against the side of the tool to set it parallel with the bar. Another way of setting the thread cutting tool square
is to use your driving plate and just check that it's square to the driving plate.
Or if your work's in the chuck, you can use the flat face of the jaw, check your tool's square to that. I've put some marking blue on the part. I've set my compound slide to 29 degrees. I'm just bringing this in. Engage the lead screw. It should move forward. Stop it on the end. I've set my cross slide to zero. I can wind my cross slide out, reverse the lathe. Wind the cross slide back into zero. Put another cut on. I've made a cut. And try my thread gauge. That's the right pitch, 1.5. Back off the cross slide, reverse. Put the cross slide back to zero. And put a cut on with the compound slide. That's the thread finished. The next job is to bore out this, put taper in there for an ER20 collet. I'll put the three jaw chuck back on and then set this up so that this is running true, this end, then I can bore the taper. I've clocked this up to get it running true. That's a run out on it, about a tenth. And I'm setting it to the spindle because obviously that's what's going to locate in the grinding fixture. So now I want to bore the taper for the ER20 collet.
I've set the angle to about 8 degrees.
I've finished the taper. I've just polished it with some emery cloth using the stick. I've tried two methods of
getting the angle. One, using a dowel pin in the collet so that it doesn't spring. And I find this is a bit, you've got no feedback off it. The other method is just using the collet. You can feel when it grips. I don't know whether you can see the bolt. You can see that it's blue where the collet's been touching, so that's okay. The other thing is, this groove should be about just under 5 mil, which that is. So that's virtually finished now. All I need to do is take the sharp edge off there. So I'm just putting a chamfer on the inside. Be careful when you do this, because don't put your finger in the bore, because it's sharp edges, and being a taper, it will grip your finger, especially if the chuck's turning. Put the collet in the nut. That should go on okay. Is I've got no fine feed on the down, so I'm just having to tap it. That just fits on there. So far we've got this, you can move around, this can turn, and we can lock it with the spindle lock. So the next thing we need to do is a feeding system that we can feed the spindle into the grinding wheel, and also some sort of system to index it and the cutting edges on the drill. It's around 1.350. Right, I've put my centre in just to support it, stop it vibrating. I've cut a groove in here using my parting off tool, about 3 mil deep, and now I'm going to part this off on this end. Thank you. knot I've just been making. Put a groove in there. So the next thing I want to do is drill a hole through, tap it M5, put a grub screw in to lock this collet onto the spindle. Oh well, that's it for today. We'll finish the indexing ring off next week. I hope you enjoyed it and see you next time on Enots Engineering.